Hello and welcome. I'm so excited because today is the day when I will be able to present you with my favorite techniques of heart coherence. My name is Karolina Skórska and I'm owner of Be Super You. Along with Europia, we are creating those videos to support you going through the crisis. And it doesn't only mean a crisis of COVID-19, which we are all facing at that moment, but it's all the stress, all necessary tension, all the difficulties you're going through. So this is self-regulation, this is stress control, and this is resilience building techniques. Okay, then, so today we're going to talk about the technique that is having a 30 years of science behind that, and it's connected with our hearts. So it has been discovered that our heart has its own magnetic field, and through the work of cardioneurologists, it was also discovered that our heart has very similar neurological connection that our brain has. So why is that so strange? So up to that point, it was considered that this is our center of everything, and all the signals are going from our heads down our bodies, and this is how we're responding, this is how we're functioning. However, the research show that with every heartbeat, the signal is being sent back into our brains. So having this knowledge, it was understood that heart has its own intelligence, but moreover, it can influence the way we think, the way we behave, and our resilience. So how did that happen? So imagine then you are facing situation. It can be any of your life situation, but I will maybe explain that on an example from the office job for, like, let's say. So imagine then your boss is coming into you and telling you, wow, we are impressed of yourself, you're doing great. We would like to give you an opportunity to go up the ladder, and we would like to propose you to do that project for us. So, of course, you're excited. Of course, promotion sounds great. So you can't wait to start and jump into the project. And that's what you do. And this is your first level of performance. So there is a little bit of stress because, well, this is some form of the challenge, but this is this positive stress, which will probably keeps you going a little bit thanks to that positive anxiety. And then, of course, you're doing a little bit of research, then you are implementing them steps, and then you are getting into this very good performance level. But imagine, like in all our lives, we do have situation coming from a different perspective. So your boss is coming into you and saying, well, we know that you are working on that project and we do appreciate that. We see that you're doing great. However, we have this very important client. And if you want to be higher up the level, you need to kind of consider that. And we would like you to join the other project as well. But unfortunately, that will mean then you will need to stay at work for a little bit longer and sometimes weekends. And okay, fair enough, one of those situations, then you can't say no to, because you know that's not going to be too over your lifetime. That's going to be just few weeks of longer hours work for you to get up the ladder, to be on a higher position, to earn better money. But then on the other side, it's your family who are not going to be this happy from this situation over a period of time as well. So what is happening? So you are like getting, like you are performing on that level for a little while, but then being overwhelmed with the work and with all responsibility outside of work, you are getting into the stage when you are a little bit how you are getting into this hyperreactive stage. And on this level, you are getting a bit worried whether you will manage all responsibilities at once? How will that come out? If you don't have this much time than you would like to have on each of aspect of your life. And this is when we are getting into our head. So when we are jumping back into this level, what is happening here with our performance, it starts to be like dropping a little bit, because our worry and anxiety definitely not supporting our energy level or our creativity. If we will stay within this performance, so within that state, we will get even farther, because that will get you at some point, because of the worry and because of the stress and because of like increased workload, you will start to be a little bit drained. You will start to be emotionally exhausted. And this is when your creativity and other things are just dropping. If that's going to last for longer, and if you don't stop there, that will eventually get you into the state of breakdown, and even can have like massive effect on your health. Okay, but what we can do about that? So we can choose to do things differently. I would like to show you that index I'm just talking about. So this is much more, I've explained that like to you on a situation, but if you look on that graph, this is where we have this increased performance. This is when we have this optimal point. And this is when most of the situation have its extra situation that will affect our performance. So that might be an extra project, that might be an extra tasks at home, that might be that your kid will get ill within, for example, the situation that we were talking about. But I also believe that's moment of option, because if we carry on like that, it will always get that into the same point. At this point, we're not going to like that job anymore. And you probably had them situation then, because you've took too much, or you've decided that you will manage, you've just kind of gave up on something, because at some point that wasn't this interesting anymore. But if we choose to choose our resilience technique, this is when our performance will just be slowly increasing, or at least staying on that level of high performance. Okay, but this is theory. So how we can do that? And what I love the most from the heart math is the simplicity of the actual techniques, but moreover is the fact that it can be used within the time of the event. So you don't have to go away from whatever you do to use the technique, but you can actually start implementing them in the real time, in a real situation, for you to be able to self-regulate. Coming back to self-regulation and to our graph. So again, if you haven't watched a video about self-regulation, please come back to it, only because this is the moment then you need to actually recognize that something is going on. So you need to catch the moment of this hyperactivity. So catch the moment then you are a bit like on the run, then it's not dissatisfying anymore, then you are a bit tired, then you're not this creative, then something is going on in your life that might affect you to start rolling down the slope. So what we can do? So I will introduce you to two beautiful techniques today. So first one is heart-focused breathing. And I would like you to sit down comfortably to start with, and I will guide you through that technique. So start breathing a little bit more deeply and with the longer breaths, inhales and exhales, that you would normally do. Just concentrate on the breathing. You can think about the pattern. So, for example, inhale up to five, one, two, three, four, five, and exhale, one, two, three, four, five. You can adjust the number for you to be comfortable as long as your breathing is a little bit longer and deeper than normally. Perfectly. So what I would like you to do now, I would like you to shift your attention into your heart. And there are a few ways to do that. So you can either imagine that there is a small lift that will take you down from your head while breathing deeply, of course, through your throat, through your chest, into inside of your heart. Or you can imagine then you're breathing through the heart. So you can imagine then your long, nice inhale are through the heart and your amazing long exhales are through the heart as well. Or you can just place your hand on your heart to feel its amazing energy. And stay there for a moment. You might find then your attention is coming out of the heart. So when you recognize that, please come back, trying to concentrate on a quality of breath. Have you ever been inside your heart? How does it feel? So try to stay in your heart. And in the meantime, I will explain to you another technique, but I will start when should you be doing that, what you're just doing. So you should be like waking up and doing like at least 3 minutes first thing in the morning, just to connect yourself with the heart. Then last thing at night to clear your headspace. And when you listen to someone, because it's nothing more respectful than listen to the other person from the inside of your heart. And you might discover that when you do that, you might hear completely different things as well. They might not go through all the perception through your head, but they will go through inside of your heart. And you might hear more information than you would normally do. But you should do that as often as that possible as well, just to encourage this heart-brain connection to establish, because the more you practice, the easier for you be just to drop your attention down into your heart and use this facility and use this amazing energy to support you. So this is our turning down on emotion. So this is our leveling down our stress level. But another technique, it's called quick coherence. So if you went out of your heart, come back there. So again, start breathing a little bit more deeply, slower. And shift your attention from your head to your heart. And again, you can use the lift. You can touch your heart, or you can just imagine then you're breathing through the heart. That's great. And now, recall the sensation or the feeling of love, compassion, care, or appreciation. You can just focus on the situation from your life. So for me, bringing appreciation, it's always the moment when I'm sitting with my legs soaked into the warm sand in front of the ocean. You can see me just smiling now. Or if I think about my boy, so my little son, and it's automatically flaring up. So try to stay focused within your heart on this appreciation feeling. And again, using the quality of breath over period of this exercise. That will activate the regeneration and getting yourself into the harmony and positive state. Will your decision be different, made from that state, that made from the anger? They probably will. I would suggest that you practice the first technique, so heart focus breathing for a week, just as I mentioned, to create this connection in between your heart and mind. And then after a week, add up a quick coherence. So additionally, kind of this renewing feeling of love, appreciation, and try to stay within that state. Use that in the real time of the events. So if you are getting like into argument with your partner, if you are a bit of fed up at work, if you hear something in the news that you're not happy with, just jump into that heart and just stay there and just see how your body is adjusting amazingly with every heartbeat. There is much more science behind those techniques, so I would like to invite you into Be Super You. We will be slowly implementing that for you. Although I'm not the greatest person to stick to social media, I will try my best to give you some more information and maybe other techniques. I would like you to comment on those videos and tell us what you've noticed, whether you've enjoyed it, whether that make you feel differently. So please feel free to email me with your queries or with whatever you think about that. Thank you so much for this journey today. I hope you've enjoyed it. And I will see you next week when we will be talking about assertiveness. Take care. Stay healthy. Bye-bye.